Hi friends, hope you performed very well in the preliminary examination. Even I gave the exam good and I'm scoring around a range of 115 to 123. I think it's not a bad score. So after the successful completion of Art and Culture series, I'm going to start World History, which is a very new series. And here I'm going to cover the entire syllabus for the mains examination. So before going to that, I want to share with you how my videos really help you in the examination. So total there were 7 questions which were covered in the exam from my videos, and I can't say it's a direct question. There are a lot of indirect questions. We can solve it easily with a simple logic and understanding. So starting with this question, it's a complete indirect question, but I made videos like dynasty wise contribution to Indian art and culture. So with that knowledge we can solve this question. And these are some of the proofs how the question was covered in the video. So again, coming to this second question, it's from modern history, and I made separate videos on moderates and extremists, and you can solve it easily. And it is a very direct question and easy question. And coming to this question on classical language, I covered this point in Indian language and literature video. And also with a simple logic, we can solve it very easily. And coming to this question, it's from polity, and I made separate videos on Panchayati Raj institutions, and it's an indirect question, and this was also covered with this two points here. And coming to this question that is on Kalamkari painting, it was covered in Indian painting video. And it is a direct question with a simple logic, as here it's mentioned, it's Andhra Pradesh, it's a screenshot from my video, and here in the examination it's pointed like South India. So it's a very simple logic. And coming to this question on geographical indication status, this question is from my Indian crafts video, and it was expected before the prelims, and clearly mentioned the reason why it's going to come in the preliminary examination. So somewhat it's a guess, and it worked out. And coming to this final question, that's a seventh question, it's a previous question, it's a repeated question. It was also covered in the Buddhism video as a screenshot of the question. So coming back to this world history series, and I'm going to cover all the important topics for mains examination. So in these videos I'm going to focus more on the keywords with the supporting pictures, and this series goes on in this method only, with the main focus on keywords with images. So starting with this industrial revolution, in this topic we are going to deal with the key events that made industrial revolution possible, and the development of industrial revolution in two stages, and also the nature of industrial revolution, what are the main causes for the industrial revolution, and what are the different paths that led to the industrial revolution, the spread of the industrialization, and also the right significance of the industrial revolution. And ultimately, the final thing, that's the effects. It may be in three ways, that is the economic effects, the social effects, and finally, it's the political effects. So these are the things I'm going to deal in industrial revolution. And coming to this American Revolution, so what are the main causes for the outbreak of American Revolution? And finally, the results and the causes for the success of America and the failure of Great Britain, and finally the American Constitution. So these are the things which I'm going to deal in American Revolution. Sorry. And in French Revolution, what are the different political conditions of Europe on eve of this French Revolution, and what are the main causes for the outbreak of French Revolution and the role of French philosophers, and finally the results of the revolution, and also the course of the revolution. So these are the things which are going to deal with the French Revolution. And coming to this France after revolution, Napoleon, Vienna Congress, and the concert of Europe. So we are going to learn about the working of a national assembly and the working conditions of the National Convention, and Napoleon as a ruler of France, the Vienna a peace settlement, and also finally it's a concert of Europe. And coming to this imperialism and colonialism, we're going to touch the concept of imperialism and the early effects of colonization and the impact of colonialism. So these are the things which I'm going to deal with, the imperialism and colonialism. And coming to this era of Metternich, that is the 1830 and 1848 revolutions. So we are going to clearly examine the causes and the results of 1830 and 1848 revolutions. So in this unification of Italy, so what is a thing like the rise of nationalism? What is the main reasons for the failure of revolts of 1848-49, the role of Garibaldi and the role of foreign elements in the unification of Italy? And we are going to deal with these things. And coming to this unification of Germany, here we have to concentrate on the themes of romantic revivalist movement and also the German unification. So, and again, the Bismarck's idea of German unification, and finally the war with Austria and France. In Eastern question, Crimean War and the Balkan Wars. So here we are going to clearly examine the European powers' interest in the question and also the reasons, the revolts in the empire, and the Russo-Turkish War and the Congress of Berlin. And we are going to analyze the different events in this Balkan Wars after the Congress of Berlin and the Young Turk Movement. And in the Communist Revolution in Russia, we are going to deal with the causes and the results of Russian Revolution. And in this topic of First World War, Paris Peace Settlement and the League of Nations, so we are going to clearly identify the causes and consequences for the First World War, and also analysis on the Paris Peace Settlement, and finally the organization achievements and also causes for the failure of League of Nations. And in Communist Revolution in China, we are going to deal with the Long March 1934 and the Civil War in China, and the victory of the communists and the fail of the nationalists, and finally the results of the revolution. And coming to this rise of Japan, we have to mainly focus on one thing, like how a small Asian country like Japan, by doing some reforms, it became a great power in the world by 1919. So this is a main focus question on the rise of Japan. And coming to this rise of fascism and Nazism in Germany, we are going to specially focus on Mussolini and Hitler. So these are the two areas we are going to deal with: fascism in Italy and Nazism in Germany. And in the Second World War, UNO, here the main area is on the causes of the Second World War and the important battles and the consequences of the war, and also the origin, like objectives and achievements of UNO. And finally, in the Cold War and the regional pacts, we are going to deal with the different phases of the Cold War and the emergence of these regional pacts and their impact. And finally, it's the effects of the Cold War. And last but not the least, it's the political philosophies in modern world. So in the next video, I'm going to start with the Industrial Revolution. And please like the video, subscribe, share and comment. And finally, thank you, and thank you again for giving me this beautiful opportunity. Thank you.